learning and memory in the hippocampus is dependent on activation of the NMDA receptors, or the glutamate receptors, which are perhaps the most potent neurotransmitter in the brain. What we know is that lead and stress are both potent inhibitors of the NMDA receptor activity, and that both lead and stress impact the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis. Not only do they both impact them, but the combination of lead and a stressful environment are synergistic in this regard. So this study looked at lead-exposed rodents and then followed them during their growth and development by having one group that was raised in an enriched social environment and another that was raised in what's a standard environment. So what's an enriched environment for a rodent? There's maybe a few more toys, and there are more rodents per cage, so there's more interaction and play. And then they looked at learning, memory, and NMDA receptor activity. Well, lead affected learning and memory, and it decreased those abilities. And the NMDA receptor activity was also decreased in those that were lead exposed. But if the group that were lead exposed, but then were raised in an enriched environment, the impacts of lead on cognition were dramatically reduced, and that the NMDA receptor activity, or part of this mechanism for its effect, was normalized. So does this relate to what happens in humans? Well, we do know from some studies that environmental enrichment may ameliorate some of the neurocognitive effects of pollutants that we're exposed to. So one example is the study of lead exposure in children in Mexico City. And what Bellinger found was that lead exposure at low levels, below 10 micrograms per deciliter, the cognitive impacts were only seen in those from less advantaged households. Whereas with higher levels of lead exposure, greater than 10 micrograms per deciliter, effects were seen in both advantaged and the less advantaged households, but the effect was ameliorated to some degree in the advantaged households. We know additionally from PCB, polychlorinated biphenyl studies, that the prenatal effect seen on neurocognition was only actually seen in the families that had a less optimal parent and home characteristic score. And that breastfeeding was protective of one of the effects, which was on attention at school age. So that might indicate that a closer relationship, a less stressful early environment, was also ameliorative. And then in a study in New York City of exposure to secondhand smoke, there was the greatest cognitive impact on those that had unmet basic needs in the areas of food, housing, and clothing. So again, I think that these emphasize that environmental enrichment may be effective in ameliorating neurocognitive effects of environmental exposures.